right, ladies and gentlemen. It's a day later. I'm back on here. Okay. It's got the wrong title on it. I'll have to change the title. Right, I'll do that now. Sorry about that. We all make mistakes. Right, so just change this quickly. Sorry about this, ladies and gentlemen. And we update that, so now it should say 7 days to die, part 5, move to the new base. Yes, that's better. Okay. This is the old base, obviously. I've sit on my bed here, so I should spawn here if I die. I haven't set up a residential area in the new base yet, so you've seen all this before. And I have stripped the place empty now. So there's only the bed here. My new base is over there. So, I create, well, I've done quite a bit of work actually. It was going to be my mine, but after a while I decided, well, why not use this space? So, put an electrical system in, obviously, I've got guns up here. Any zombies come anywhere near within the range, and it's bang bang time automatic. So, here we go, into my new base. First things first. The underground guy. I can get there from inside my base, but not from here. But you need this opening so the sun can get to the plants. It's got to be within 8, I think. It's either 8 or 10 blocks of the surface. Otherwise it won't work. So, this is my workshop. It's a nice purple colour. Got a permanent water supply over here, also cooling off pool. Cooking. This area isn't done yet, but it's going to be the residential area, so the bedrooms and stuff will be a bedroom, bathroom, living area, guest rooms, workbench and all that. Everything placed in a storage area, nicely done out, labelled. Right, but then this area isn't totally complete. This is the garden and the blood moon arena now. Happy Samhain, or Happy Halloween, or Happy Samhain, whichever you pronounce it. To everybody. I say Samhain, a lot of other pagans say Samhain. But yeah, at the moment I'm growing stuff to get seeds so I can plant more stuff. Just all the stash of stock. 25 squares is more than enough because I got 4 points on living off the land, so it gives 4 back per seed planted. I can't complain. As in this area doesn't lead anywhere, but it's just good dead. But I will be going down that corridor. You will be able to turn left at some point, go for about 50 to 100 yards, and then it'll be a ladder going up to the Blood Moon Arena, which will be a killing zone for just set for Blood Moon, so I won't have to go over to the school and stuff. I can do it straight here, do Blood Moon. Far enough away from the base so I don't hit the base with any of my shots as I'm trying to shoot the zombies. Yeah, but, it'll be good. But this is it. This is the new base. I like building underground. I normally don't build this close to the surface, normally it's right down the bedrock. What I'm going to do, I'm going to gather a little bit of wood, ladies and gentlemen. There's a lot more than that. Stone. I'm still going to use the school for tonight's lesson. It's convenient. I have strengthened the school up a little bit. Lag spike below there, though, for some reason or other. The internet is playing up today. Probably said Herbert is playing his chicken conquest game. Of course, the kids over here are going on holiday, aren't they? They get too many holidays. They really do. The kids should be in school permanently. Till they're 18. The whole point of education. I'm educated. So you don't grow up being a dumbass. Nowhere. I've spotted here, we've got... what is this? I can't remember what it's called, but... Snowberries, of course. Which, in excess, can be rather poisonous to us, but... Small resources. That's the end of the family. Eggs I need to collect. Come on, you really shout your nonsense, mate. Oh, you shouted for you're dead, you can't feel pain. So why does somebody shout? I've asked this question before. How does a screaming thing go on? What about? You're dead. Your pain receptors, you are deceased. You're functioning. So why does all these fall? Is it the fact they're dead? They miss life? What? Have someone explain that. I wonder where my buddy Jumper Take is going online today. At what time will Steve Solo become online? It is an official question. It has to be asked. And then, of course, the awesome Reaper, where is she? Is she here? Oh, that was a Scarlet Pimpernel, wasn't it? Sexist, this thing is going to be a woman. Probably was a woman, but couldn't be. Anything a man can do, a woman can do generally. We are pretty equal in our regards. So I don't understand this whole men are better at this, women are better at this. Apart from the biological imperatives, of course. That's like stuff. But, you know, are men good at giving birth to babies? No. Are women? Professionals. Professionals. There's no argument about that. Why? Because that is a biological imperative, female anatomy. Male body? Not so much. Even though, a man did have a baby back in the day, I can't remember it since, but see, that's all scientific and misinformation or fucking around with things they shouldn't be messing around with. Really. Yeah, they're not born to give birth, they're born to help in the seeding of birth. Birth, help in the seeding. I don't understand the whole argument there. This is quite the deck more. Don't do it in the sample energy. Here's our big one. I think the movie, the first movie of the series, Return of the Living Dead, up in 84, 85, explained in one sentence when they questioned the zombie they'd captured and tied to a table, or half a zombie, I should say. Is it still a zombie if it's conscious? Like, living conscious. But they asked the question, you know, why do you eat people? And they said, not people, brains. And so they said, okay, why do you eat brains? And the zombie answered, pain. What pain? Pain of being dead, so apparently it hurts to be dead, he says. The actor, Tom Calfer, it hurts to be dead, he's a mortician in the Great Book. It hurts to be dead. So that sort of answered the question in a way. I don't know, it hurts to be dead. It's a lot to take in, that really. So I'll put all this into storage because I might not use it. Then again, one of the other members of the group might. There we are, the Tallywhacker streaming community. See? What is that? Battlefield 2. I still have Battlefield 2. Some colour I wear. No, I'm not a goth. I just like the colour black. Proper black. True black. bit of friendly offline laugh. Elon Musk and whenever I look at Elon Musk, no disrespect to Elon Musk, but he just looks like an elongated mollusk. That's what I call it, Elon Mollusk. Yeah, Elon Mollusk I call it. My friend just started laughing because he thought it was so funny. I said, what? He said, he does look a bit like a snail, doesn't he? Like somebody showed a snail's head on top of him before. I started laughing as well. Yeah. Sad to say. Genius old guy, though. Yeah. Fair play to a man, like. Won't knock his genius. But you wish you had his money? No, I don't. That's one thing I don't think about. See, yeah. Not everybody on the planet is orientated around money. I'm not, I never have been. Yes, sadly, it's needed to survive in society and life. I don't crave it, I don't. Like some people, it's all you see, they after money all the time, they do anything for money. I'm not that way inclined. Never have been. More important to me is having fun, enjoying the time that you have here on this planet. And just, you know, somebody asked me a little while back as well, what, you know, when you're gone, what would be the epitaph if you have a grave or a grave marker or, you know, something to mark that you existed? What would it be? I don't wish to swear because I don't swear that often, but I thought the best epitaph for me would be this. Thank fuck that's over. A couple of simple words. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank fuck that's over. Obviously, you'd have to have asterisks instead of certain letters, otherwise, they'd probably never allow it. But yeah, I think that's a perfect epitaph for me. It says how I feel about life, the way the world is. Greedy, crappy world run by greedy, crappy people. That's all right. Yeah, my feelings are right here. Get to my spot. I'm trying to get to my spot. That's exactly where I should be. being that the zombies on this game make me laugh, actually. They're chasing a big chop, biggest chop in the bar we've ever seen. All the ladies have their chocolate. They do. They have other chocolate too. Well, I hope I would have missed the paper. I'll do that. Yeah, sadly, and I don't like doing it if I have to use my admin powers just now. Time caught me up and I wanted to be a I'd set this up earlier. But I have to teleport, which has really annoyed me. And I have to use an admin tool. I don't like using it. I like to do it properly. But, I'm here now. I'm just going to continue. I'll have to use it again in a minute of the bullets and then take some bullets and throw them away. Okay, flip them. Ooh, swine. Oh, fat boy, bring it on. As a person of larger stature, I can see that. Because I ain't thin. Yeah, I watched Zombieland 2 a lot back. I didn't even know it existed. It was good, I enjoyed it. I think it played a lot on the first movie. Reliving it, it was very similar. Very, very similar. Living off its, what makes this original. But no, good film, we'll see. Never seen Zombie actually. It was worth the hour and a half, whatever it was. Yeah, sometimes ain't worth pissing on things. Especially if they like, I won't name names, but the original two movies back in the 80s with Bill Murray and Dan Aykroyd, the other two, I can't remember their names. With the green slimy thing going on the place. Great movies. The one that came out a couple of years back? Yeah. actually been cut. Very soon version. I haven't seen the new one that's out now. I haven't seen that one yet. Which is officially apparently part 3. Afterlife is called? I think it's Afterlife. I'm not sure to be honest. I've heard some good things about it. So hopefully it'll live up to my expectations. Makes you think when you see them lights on this. Because there's a sign you can get on here called Roswell is this distance away, and I'm thinking, are they trying to say this entire zombie apocalypse is caused by alien intervention? Are they hinting at it? Or, oh, are they? Do that anything? Really? Bleeding, okay. And then antibiotics or honey. Sure. A couple of bullets left. Losing wisely. Steel crossbow bolts always do it for me. You're playing with a scum where you will pop. One of them's exploded, so that sort of helped the situation a little bit. How's that, Buffy? Are they in, buddy? Oh, they are in. How did they get in? Swans. Oh. See, that is wrong. More zombies should be that bloody powerful. Wow. That did some damage. This song. See, no zombie should make that much damage, but that's just wrong. That is so wrong. I have to get my Bloodborne Arena up and running for the next level. With gun turrets and spikes. For this place. They lead their way through this eventually. They lead this collapse. Ooh, silly boy, they're just shot people with heads so much. How many headshots can you survive? Oh yeah, you're regenerating, aren't you? If you want to be a radiated one. A pain cushion. Down you go, stay down. Too much. Okay. And he still gets back up. Hey, Fun Pimps, what the hell is wrong with you? These are zombies, they're not supposed to be this powerful. This will be 15, okay, maybe at 4, so the zombies should end. do actually start to dissipate in the moment. Kill boys down. Cheerleader. Hey Mickey, also probably wants to come and join me on here, Mickey. Stand still while I'm trying to shoot you. Yeah. Crossbow bolts and arrows are not free. Why do you still keep going? Not for long, come on. Right, okay. We did some damage. Clearly we did some damage. Yes, they did. Oh god, I'm loaded up as well, aren't I? Base quickly, drop off a load of stuff, and then come back and fix some of this damage. Can't believe it. Bloody vultures. Or evil pigeons as a former friend. Seen the last one, you know. My gun saw it. I'm taking a check what this is doing. Well, this is doing good. Okay. Oh, hold up, hold up, hold up. I It sounds like it's the buzzards, or the vultures, the guns are going for. The buffalo bastards too. Yeah. Teach them a lesson, wouldn't it? Weapons. See, I'll chuck all this stuff in here for others. I've got no interest in guns, really, on this. I'll have a sniper rifle, of course. Look at my armour, I said, yeah, I don't think I've got one. What do I look like? I look like a right tit. That's what I look like, to be honest. I do have one there, right, under the other. It's right with the cupboard. Okay. Okay. And where? Right. I put this into my personal stash. Collecting the black mods. Collecting that, obviously. Seeds cupboard. Yes. Okay, looking good, huh? Put it into the schematics cupboard. Yeah, repo will probably be on there at some point. You need to learn that. So, yeah, it's all good. It benefits everybody. Mods, yeah. No mods in there. I'm having that. What's good in there? Okay, buddy. Alright. It's cool drink. Medicinal. Poppy powder. Scrap that. I collect 10 of all of them eventually. I don't even name them, I just like them to be there. Yeah. Just the way I roll. What we have here, we'll have coffee and then we'll have beer or hops. Well, they've grown. Captain bullets. Bullets for my gun turrets. Shotgun shells. See, I like to use shotgun turrets on my actual Blood Bowl arena. I find they use less rounds and they do a lot more damage. No, don't check it on the floor with the tent. If I go to school, I'll go back to the school. For now, I've done my bit down here. Yes, I have. I'm going to take a break, get dinner, lunch up and running. Part 5 is complete now. So, viewer, thank you for sticking with me. Your loyalty is boundless. It's awesome. Thank you very much. And actually, just going to have some food. And then I'll be back for a bit more. What you enjoy. So take care and catch you soon. Black Sheep out.